Hello everyone. Today let me share with you an electrical device known as an AC line splitter. In this instance, I have an example, one of the kinds of AC line splitter, the Newstar UT TSA-22. What is the purpose of an AC line splitter? The AC line splitter allows us to use a clamp meter to measure current flowing through a load when we are connecting normal or low power, low voltage household loads to a wall outlet using plug connectors like this one. You might say, why not just clamp the whole conductor, the whole extension cord, and measure current? Unfortunately, clamp meters does not work that way. In this simple diagram, a load is connected to a 230 volt 60 hertz AC supply. This could be a wall outlet in our houses. Now line 1 and line 2, for the load to consume current, the current coming from the voltage source must return again also to the voltage source. Now, line 1, when current is flowing through it, will develop an electromagnetic force around it, so does line 2, but in opposite direction. If we connect the clamp meter on both conductors, on both line 1 and line 2, like in this example, I connect it to line 1 and line 2, the electromagnetic force of both lines will cancel each other out, and the core of the clamp meter would not be able to tell the difference. It will just register as zero. So in order to measure the current going to the load, either only line 1 or line 2 must be clamped, not both at the same time. So either this one or this one, this will work, but not both at the same time. This extension cord that I made myself is already a line splitter. They serve the same purpose, but the reason why I still bought this Newstar line AC line splitter is that there is a multiplier of 10 in one of its legs. There is a multiplier of 1 and a multiplier of 10. So the way this works is that to measure current going to a load, you connect this one to the voltage source and you connect your load here, and then clamp the jaws of the clamp meter either at X1 or X10. So what exactly is meant by X1 and X10? To answer that question, we need to open this AC line splitter. This is the inside of the Newstar AC line splitter. The construction is quite simple. We can immediately see that this terminal post here represents the equipment grounding connection. And this is this could be line 1 and line 2. As you can see, line 1 goes from this terminal location all the way straight to the terminal point here, where the load is connected, while the other line, this is line 2, passes also on this part here, but when it came to this hole, it is wound 10 times before going to its final terminal point in this location. So for example, if the load connected here is drawing 3 amperes of current, we would be reading 3 amperes if clamped in this location here, in either this one, this place, or in this place. Both 3 amperes. If we clamp in this part here, we would be reading 30 amperes. That is because the electromagnetic force being induced on the core of the clamp meter is magnified 10 times, so we would expect to read 30 amperes in the display. We'll just divide that one by 10 to get the correct reading of 3 amperes. In as much as I have already opened the line splitter, I might as well comment on its build quality. I would say that the build quality is quite decent. And as you can see, the construction is quite simple, but rather robust. The soldering works appeared fine. The only thing I am not very excited about is that the Voltec points here, this is the place where you can test for voltage, is quite small and takes a bit of pressure. And in this case, the tip of my test leads will not even fit. Let's try some example here. I will connect my electric fan to the load side of the line splitter, and noting that this is the X1 part and this is the X10. Now my Hioki 3288-20, an AC and DC current clamp meter, can only measure down to 600 milliamperes, although it can measure up to a high of 1000 amperes. Let's try if it can detect anything at X1. So zero at X10. It detects a current now of 2.6 amperes. So if we divide it by 10, since I am clamping here at the X10 part, I get a reading of around 270 milliamperes, or 0.270 amps. Let's check that one with the Fluke clamp meter, which is able to measure down to 100 milliamperes. So correct, so I'm getting a reading of 0.27 also. So my readings here corresponds to each other, and incidentally this shows the accuracy. These are good indicators of the accuracy of both my Fluke 3204 and my Hioki 3288-20. I'd just like to point out that this line splitter is a low power 230 volt 15 ampere testing device for measuring purposes only, so make sure that you do not exceed the maximum ampere rating here of 15 amperes, and just to be safe, limit your current to no more than 10 amperes. I'd appreciate your comments and suggestions. If you have any comments, please write them down below, and stay safe. Thank you for watching.